I think we have great opportunities here, and I think we can do this. Matter of fact, I know we can do this. We're Americans. We can do this, and we can make things happen, and we can get things to work as long as we get the government out of our way, which is exactly what I want to do, is get the government out of our way. I said to the party and to both, frankly, to both parties, I'm only the second Republican ever in my family. So I've told both parties for a long time, get out of my way. Let me produce. My great-grandfather, the first Republican in my family, owned 98-some% of what you and I know today as Bexley, Ohio. And I do mean he owned it all. And that's who, and it was because he had the freedom and the abilities to do that, not being regulated and legislated out of business and out of existence, and being told what to do by somebody in Columbus who thinks they know better than we do. We know how to take care of our kids and educate them. We know what's best for our businesses. We know what's best for our county and our district and our state and our country. And that's what we need to do. And so I'm asking for your vote on May 4th to make that happen. I'm running basically a word-of-mouth campaign. You want to take money out of politics? Well, I'll show you how to do it. This is how you do it. You just do it. Everybody's complaining about how much money's in politics. Well, I'm not taking any money from anyone or anything. I have enough of my own money. And that's how it should be. That's how it used to be. It isn't about how much money I can raise and spend. It's about what we are going to do and what I'm going to help us do. With your help, I will do it. By doing a word of mouth campaign, when I get to Columbus, who's going to argue with me? Only thing I'm going to do is reach out and pull out my cell phone and call a few of you and say, these guys aren't doing what you elected me to do. Will you guys help me out here a little bit? And you guys will call the rest of the state of Ohio and burn up their phones and say, look, we elected him to get rid of property taxes. We elected him to eliminate a lot of things here and cut taxes all the way across the board, at least 50 or 60%. You want to see economic growth? You want to see how things can work and grow? Cut the taxes. It worked with Reagan. I think Reagan didn't go far enough, personally. It works every time. And that's what we need to do. And that's what you get with me. So I appreciate your support, and thank you for being here this evening. And all of you, drive safely home.
Thank you. My opponent and I do disagree on a few things, but we do agree on the fact that we do need less government. And that is where I put my name on the line. I also can tell you that I'm a straight shooter. You talk to anybody that knows me, have known me all my life. I do not sugarcoat things. I tell it the way it is, and if I don't know something, then I try to find out how to do it. And you have to work with, even though you don't like government, once you get elected to this position, you have to work with the government. If you don't work with the government, you're not going to get anything done. If we want to make government smaller, then I have to work with the other representatives and the senators, and we have to work together in order to accomplish what we need to accomplish. Yes, I do believe in lower taxes. I would like to see taxes eliminated. I didn't start taxes, but I follow the rules. I do what I can. I listen to everybody. If you want, I-71 widened, I will go to bat for you. If you don't want 71 widened, let me know. I will do what you ask me to do, and that's my pledge to you. I have been a public servant my life, most of my life. Being a public servant, I know that I have to listen to people, and I do what you ask me to do. And so therefore, that is why I'm running again, because I know I can do what you want me to do. If that is, like I said, lower taxes, if we, I will do what I can to lower your health care, although I do believe people should have an opportunity to have the option of health care. We didn't even get into that discussion. But anyhow, I do believe that the Republican Party has a platform. We do have a plan. We do have a way of spurring economic growth. We have a plan to lower taxes. We have a plan to control health care. We have a plan to strengthen our schools. We need to educate our kids, because they are our future leaders. Now, whether you educate them from homeschooling or if you send them to public school, that should be your option. You can, and this is America, and you can do that. So I just want to make this the best place that you can live, you can work, worship, raise your family here. So I ask for you to make it a rule on May the 4th, and let me continue my job that I want to do for you. Thank you.
Well, we want to thank everyone for coming to the debate of the Republican candidates for both the Ohio 19th Senate District and the Ohio 90th House District. Specifically, we want to thank Patrick Quinn, Margaret Ann Ruhl, Tom Collier, and Lou Petros for participating in tonight's event and taking time out of their busy schedules to come and let their points of view be known on a variety of issues. The Knox County Republican Women's Club sponsored this event, and we invite all of you, if you're not already a member, to join. We'd like to do things such as this. Next month we're going to have an open forum debate at SIPS about some of the issues that are going on around our community. Men and women alike can join our club. So don't think just because it's the Knox County Republican Women's Club that men aren't invited. We like to have everyone come and participate to get there, to talk about some of the issues and to debate the issues and to help garner support for the Republican Party. Finally, when you came in tonight, there was a 50-50 raffle, and we're going to announce the winner of that. Jed Malik will hopefully have someone pick out the winning ticket. And the winning ticket number is 766-210. Dr. Jennifer Ogle won tonight's 50-50 raffle. Congratulations. How many dollars, Deb? Great. So again, thank you all for coming. I believe the candidates may be sticking around for a few minutes if you want to ask them any specific personal questions. I'm sure they'd be happy to entertain them. And we hope to see you all next month at the Republican Women's Club. Thanks again, everyone. Drive safe.